everyone, and welcome to my new Dory Paint video. And today I'm starting a series of Halloween special makeovers, and I was not really going to make lots of them. I was planning to take some one monster high doll, turn her into something scary and creepy, and that's it. But strangely enough, the whole topic, the theme of Halloween, has become very, I don't know, inspiring for me, so I just couldn't choose one look out of dozens of different ideas. So in the end, now we will have 3 Halloween special dolls this year, and today is the first one. And by the way, this makeover today wouldn't be possible without you, because you gave me an idea to make what I'm going to make today. Because some weeks ago, when I was transforming Barbie Fashionista doll into Nikki Tutorials, I've asked you to write in the comments under that video who were your favorite bloggers, YouTubers. And really, I learned a lot of cool people from there. I subscribed lots of new channels, and one of them was Alex from Made You Look channel. Strangely enough, I didn't know a lot about special effects makeup before. So when I for the first time found Alex and her channel, Made You Look channel, I watched probably 20 or 30 videos in one turn. And as a result of my new obsession, new interest, has become the makeover of the day, because today I'm going to recreate one of the looks, one of the makeup tutorials that Lex shows on her channel. And it's gonna be this, or this, where it should appear somewhere here, clone makeup. Because my next 2 makeovers will be kind of more dark and creepy and scary and bloody. So today I've decided to choose more such a cartoonish look, maybe a little bit less creepy, but still full of Halloween spirit. So I'm going to take a Barbie doll, because I'm going to recreate this makeup not on my own face like people normally do, but on a Barbie doll's face. So I'm going to look now in my stock, see what I have still from big Barbie doll heads. I'm going to take one of them and step by step repeat everything what is going on in the tutorial on Made You Look channel made by Lex. So let's take our doll and let's start the makeover. Let's go. So I've chosen this big doll head. You've seen her sisters already a couple of times in my videos, and everything is very standard here. Some hair accessories, a mirror, a brush. So first of all, I'm going to cut her hair very short, because this is very poor quality hair with lots of bald spots. And then with pure acetone, I will remove her makeup. Now the head is ready for transformation, and I can start following the tutorial from Made You Look. And the first step is to paint the face solid white. So I cover the doll face with a couple of layers of white acrylic paint. The next step is powdering the face, and in my case I've used the Mr. Super Clear primer to prepare the surface for drawing on it. Then Lex says that we need to make a pinwheel around her eye. But my problem is that my model has no eyes. So first of all, I'm drawing a pair of eyes on the doll's face. We can see that the clone, the end result, has different eyes. One is light green, and another one looks like a pinwheel as well, red and white. So let's sketch the pinwheel eye already now. With gray pencils, I work on the white of her eyes.
So now I can finally get back to the makeup tutorial and draw the pinwheel around her eye like it was planned from the beginning. Lex is doing it immediately with red paint, but I'm going to help myself a little bit. So first I'm drawing a circle around her eye, then I'm sketching the triangles with a light pencil, and just then I'm coloring them red. Then I'm taking a darker pencil and I'm shading each triangle shape. Then I apply the same red color to her eyelid and also under the eye. Now I need to line the eye with a black pencil and to smudge out the liner. For my work I use Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer watercolor pencils and Rembrandt soft pastels. Now it's time to draw an evil eyebrow, and Lex works here immediately with a black pencil again. And I will again first sketch it with a lighter shade. And then we're supposed to start applying red right under the eyebrow, blending the pastels downward. And then I need to line the second eye. Thank you. I used, of course, an erasing gum to clean the eyes from the black pastels, but I still think the white areas can be refreshed a little bit. And then I also draw some highlights around her eyes to give them extra dimension. Now it's time to draw the lips. Following the tutorial, I'm filling the lips in with a red pencil, extend the ends, and then with a darker pencil, I create a dark outline. I shade the lips and the teeth a little bit extra with dark, soft pastels. Now let's work on the color. First of all, Lex draws an outline of it with white paint. But in my case, the doll's chest is already white, so I will do it with a light gray pencil. I'm drawing the stripes from her chin to the outline of the collar, and then I'm filling in the space between the stripes with the red pencil. And then I'm going to shade first the red and then the white sections. And tell me about your Halloween plans, by the way. Are you going to some party maybe, and what will be your look this year? Or just tell me about your best Halloween costume ever. I'm really curious to hear all these spooky stories. Thank you. Now we need to outline the color using a black pencil. Then we need to create two sideways teardrops in each dip of the color. And then I'm going to outline and to shade them. Then I'm going to add a couple of new drops and to repeat the shading. Now we still need to outline the entire color and to add some extra shading. I've decided to cover the part of the doll's body under the color with a light nude soft pastels. Then it will look like it's her real body with a collar on top of it. Well, now the tutorial part is over, but since we're working on a doll and not on a real person, I still want to add some tiny things, some details. First of all, with white acrylic paint, I put highlights to her eyes. And then I attach the false lashes, add glossy varnish, mainly to her eyes, and then just the slightest touch of it to the middle of her lips. Decided to give her such a blue curly wig, and I don't know why, but she reminds me Harley Quinn in some way, so I think I will do her hair in two ponytails. And here is finally my end result next to the original creation. And what do you think, guys? Me, honestly, I really love this doll. It was really a lot of fun for me following this tutorial because I really felt like I was learning something new because I had never worked in this genre before. But I will definitely continue working in this direction because I think the big doll heads are just made for special effects makeup. So I want to thank Lex and her channel for the inspiration and for the guidance today. And thank you guys for watching my doll transformation today. I'm looking forward to hear about your Halloween plans and ideas, and also to your opinion about this kind of an experiment. And by the way, a week ago I've promised you two Halloween repaints this week. The plans have been changed a little bit and you will see both of them next week. The first one on Thursday and another one on Friday, like always. And it will be a big collab video on Thursday, and some things just don't depend on me alone in such a big common projects. So still a little bit waiting, I can wait myself already to show you what I've made. That's why please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to not miss the extra video, the big Halloween transformation on Thursday. Because this time we're going to make it dark. And of course, please put your likes if you have enjoyed this video, and have a nice weekend, and see you already very soon on Thursday. Bye!